Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the Varactor diodes. The Varactor diodes are one type of PN junction diodes whose internal capacitance can be changed by applying the reverse bias voltage. So these diodes are also known as the Varicap diodes, and this term Varicap refers to the variable capacitance. Similarly, the term Varactor refers to the variable reactance. So in this diode, as we change the applied reverse bias voltage, its capacitance, or in other words, its reactance will change. And this property of the Varactor diode is useful in the many applications. Particularly, when we want to change the capacitance in the circuit using the external applied voltage, then these Varactor diodes are very useful. So because of these properties, they are used in the RF communication system. And this is the symbol of the Varactor diode. So this symbol indicates that it is a PN junction diode, but unlike the normal rectifier diode, it is intended to be used as a capacitor. So to understand the working of this Varactor diode, first of all let us see how we can change the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So for a parallel plate capacitor, the capacitance can be given as epsilon A divided by D, where A is the area of the plate, while epsilon is the permittivity of the dielectric material. And here, this D is the distance between the two plates or the thickness of this dielectric material. So for a fixed value of epsilon and A, if we change the distance between the two plates, or in other words, if we change the thickness of this dielectric medium, then the capacitance of the capacitor will change. So with the same concept, the capacitance of the Varactor diode is varied. Now as I said, this Varactor diode is also one kind of PN junction diode. Now if you have followed the previous videos on the diode, then you must be aware that in the PN junction diode, this depletion region gets formed at the junction where this P-type and the N-type material meets with each other. So this P-type material contains the excessive amounts of holes, while this N-type material contains the electrons. On the other end, if you see this depletion region, then it is a depleted of the charge carriers. So in a way, this PN junction diode behaves like a capacitor. That means here, this P-type and the N-type region acts like a conducting plates, while this depletion region acts like a dielectric medium. And we know that in this PN junction diode, as we change the applied reverse bias voltage, then the width of the depletion region changes. That means as we increase the applied reverse bias voltage, then the width of the depletion region will also increase. And as the depletion region width increases, then from this equation, we can say that the value of the capacitance will reduce. That means we can say that this capacitance is inversely proportional to the applied reverse bias voltage. And if we see the exact relation, then it can be given by the following expression, where V is the applied reverse bias voltage and Vf is the forward voltage or the built-in voltage of this diode. And here, this C0 represents the capacitance of the diode whenever it is unbiased. Now in this equation, this value of the N depends on the doping profile of the Varactor diode. So based on the doping profile, there are two types of Varactor diodes. The first one is the abrupt Varactor diode. And this is the doping profile of the abrupt Varactor diode. So as you can see, in this P-type and the N-type region, the doping concentration is uniform. But at the junction, there is an abrupt change in the doping profile. So for this type of junction, the value of N is equal to 1 by 2. So usually, these normal PN junction diodes have this abrupt junction. On the other end, this is the profile of the hyperabrupt Varactor diode. So as you can see, on both sides, the doping concentration reduces with the distance. And for this type of doping profile, the value of N is equal to 2. So from this expression, we can say that for this hyperabrupt junction, as the value of this reverse bias voltage increases, then there will be a more change in the capacitance. So in general, for the normal PN junction diode, if we see the curve of the capacitance versus the applied reverse bias voltage, then it will look like this. That means in general, any diode can be used as a variable capacitor. but the varactor diodes are optimized and manufactured in such a way that they provide a more change in the capacitance with the reverse bias voltage. So now let us see the equivalent circuit of this varactor diode. So if we apply the reverse bias voltage, then in that condition, the equivalent circuit of the varactor diode will look like this. So here, this RR is the reverse resistance of the diode and this RS is the ohmic resistance. Now typically, the value of this reverse resistance is in mega ohms, because whenever we reverse bias this diode, then only a leakage current or the reverse saturation current will flow through the diode. And that current can be represented by this reverse resistance. So for the varactor diode, to minimize this leakage current or the reverse saturation current, this reverse resistance should be as high as possible. So this is the equivalent circuit of the varactor diode at the low frequencies. But whenever it is operated at the high frequencies, then we also need to consider the parasitic capacitance and the inductance. So this is the equivalent circuit of the varactor diode at the high frequencies. Alright, so now let us see some of the important specifications of the varactor diode which we need to consider while selecting the diode for the specific application. And the first and the foremost important specifications are the capacitance range and the capacitor ratio. So if you see the datasheet of any varactor diode, then they used to specify the value of the capacitance at the different voltages. For example, as shown in the datasheet, as the reverse voltage changes from 1.2 volt to the 8 volt, then the value of the capacitance changes from around 450 picofarad to 25 picofarad. So basically, this parameter gives an idea in what range we can change the value of the capacitance for the given diode. Then the second important specification is the capacitance ratio. And this is commonly expressed as Cx divided by Cy, where X and Y are the two ends of the voltage range over which we are measuring the capacitance. For example, over here, the value of X is equal to 1.2, while the value of Y is equal to 8 volt. And it defines, as we change the voltage, then how much change will occur in the capacitance value. That means if this ratio is more, then it defines that as we change the voltage, then there will be a more change in the capacitance value. So for the hyperabrupt varactor diode, it is possible to achieve the ratios which is more than 10. While for the abrupt diodes, usually it is used to be in the range of 2 to 3. So for a better tunability of the circuit, the large capacitance ratios are desirable. Then the another specification is the leakage current or the reverse current. So as I mentioned earlier, for the varactor diode, the reverse current or the leakage current should be as minimum as possible. Similarly, the another important specification is the breakdown voltage, because these varactor diodes are operated in the reverse bias condition. So while operating these diodes, we need to make sure that the applied reverse bias voltage does not exceed this breakdown voltage, because if it exceeds, then it can damage the diode. Then the another very important parameter is the Q factor. So whenever these varactor diodes are used in the tuning circuits or in the RF filters, then for the sharp response, the diodes which has a very high Q factor should be selected. That means for the good selectivity, the value of this Q factor should be as high as possible. So these are the some performance parameters of the varactor diode. So in the end, now let us see some of the applications of the varactor diode. So as I mentioned earlier, the varactor diodes can be used in the tuning circuits. For example, as shown in the figure, here the varactor diode is employed in the tuning circuit. So for the given tuning circuit, the resonant frequency FR is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi times under root LC dash, where C dash is the summation of this CT and the CC. So here, this CT is the capacitance of this varactor diode, while the CC is the coupling capacitor. So as you can see, as we change the applied reverse bias voltage, then we can change the value of this capacitor. So in this way, we can tune the circuit to the particular frequency. So these varactor diodes are used in the FM receivers as well as in the communication equipments where the circuit needs to be tuned electronically. Apart from that, they are used in the RF filters as well as in the voltage control oscillators. So these are the some of the applications of the varactor diode. So in summary, I hope you understood what is varactor diode, how it works, and what are the important specifications and the applications of the varactor diode. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.